mid-60s, I opened an architecture practice and pursued my career. I bought a house on Fifth Street and Moffett Avenue in Joplin, Missouri, where I lived for 6 years with my wife and two children. The photos show the corner of Fifth and Moffett today. He spoke with a pencil. You ask Mickey for an answer and he would start by putting pen to paper, drawing a circle, often a nautilus. That's how he's going to relate to you. He was wonderful to work with. Butch Cronlund, contractor for Post Ranch and the Esalen Bats and much, much more. Mickey Muennig became the first master of eco-minded architecture, perfecting green roof construction more than 30 years before it became the fashionable way to build. He's an unsung hero of the green movement, precisely because he never made an effort to publicize himself. Alistair Gordon. I have some memories of playing on his land, swimming in his pond, and walking up to visit Mickey, Michelle, Cass Kasparian, and Gabe, and Mary Lou, and all the creative people he surrounded himself with. Mickey was always very welcoming and didn't have a problem with neighborhood kids hanging out on his land. I also remember when he built his first structure up there with the stone walls and glass roof with a suspended bed. When I was a kid, my mom read all the Lord of the Rings books to us, and to me, Mickey was like one of the characters straight from Tolkien's mind. He truly had a magical energy about him. John Villa. I believe the architecture that people inhabit every day can turn their minds around. And I want to do that in a simple and sincere way. The best spaces can help people see and feel beyond their vision. Mickey Muennig. Thank you. Mickey built me an amazing studio in Big Sur, which is close to perfect sonically. This means you will hear each instrument playing exactly from where it is, no matter where you are in the room, and you will hear nothing else. Mickey is a first-class acoustic architect. Barclay Henry. The only way to be free in an unfree world is to become so absolutely free that your very existence is an act of rebellion. Camus. Thank you, Mickey Muennig, for being such a great and talented architect. Your work has been an inspiration to me. Visiting your buildings represented a significant experience in my academic and professional career. May the earth be light to you. Luca Guido, Architect, Venezia, Italy. Mickey's architectural achievements have shaped the Big Sur experience for locals and visitors alike for over half a century. These highly functional residential and commercial spaces interface with our beloved Big Sur coastline with a hug and a kiss. All of the elements are considered: the perpetual diversity of light sky, mountain shadows, and a moody ocean are fully embraced and factored into each design. Jonathan Newell. In my design process, I enjoy spending time with people, learning about them and what they want. And I try to develop a concept that tunes soul to structure. People have dreams that they want to incorporate into their houses, and I find that an interesting experience to work through. I observe, listen, dream, and draw. Then I listen some more, and then I draw more. Mickey Muennig. Mickey created totems to the gods on the beloved Post property. I remember him walking and camping out on the property for 2 weeks or more, feeling the site's energy and honing in on that power to create different building structures that would fit and feel just right in those spaces. I feel we accomplished the goal of having the interior spaces flow out onto the exterior landscaping and surrounding space of nature. Janet Fried. The Post Ranch Inn was Mickey's first hotel, which was not an issue, as no one associated with Post Ranch had any hotel experience. What Mickey had was a passion for design and doing something that no one else had done architecturally in the hotel business. Not only did Mickey sleep with redwoods and oak trees in order to choose the best location for each building to create a sense of privacy, but he also refused to accept conventional thinking that hotel rooms had to have right angles so that the furniture fit comfortably. Mike Fried. For me, Mickey was more than an architect. His talents was addictive, and his magic brought out the best in those of us who came under his spell. Some have called him an elf, but to those of us who have worked with him in the dirt, he was a wizard, transforming the mundane into food for the spirit. I think it was from Mickey I learned the response, "If the roof is leaking on your grand piano, move the piano." Oh, maybe that was from another famous architect. That among the builders of Mickey structures, I was privileged to get to know Bill McLeod, Tommy McDade, Peter Eichhorn, Butch Cronlund, Marty Newman, John Mearns, Charlie McClaskey, Dan Woods, and Travis Trapkus. Among the architects who worked with Mickey, we got to know and build with Daniel Piejota, Ross Levy, and Tim Bratton. Mickey lives on in the hearts of those who have come to know the magic of our own personal wizard. He now belongs to the entire world. Frank Binney.
Rescue him occasionally. I could never quite figure out why he would build a small pond at the entrance to his house inside, where in a drunken stupor he would fall in. Mickey, I'll miss you.